So it's the 18-year-old Payas Jain with the serves. Good start there. Already you can see how open this match might be.
You may get to see good rallies.
From an entertainment standpoint, that's what we want to see.
Very true.
Good control from Ricardo Walter, who just oozes class. Goes for the forehand fade, but there was quite a lot of backspin on that push. Neither player has won a point behind serve yet. There we go. Coach is treated to nice comfy sofas in the corner. Table tennis wasn't so class, you might fall asleep.
Fraser, is this the German national coach or something, or a private coach which comes with these players if they are not playing for the nation?
So Germany have quite a few coaches there. We know Jörg Waschkopf is the head coach. But there's three or four brilliant coaches for Germany.
5-1.
Across all of their national centres. Starbucken, Dusseldorf. Hutchenhausen.
Wow. You can see one of the long rallies, and that's a very difficult angle which Ricardo has taken out.
Defying physics seemingly there, the German.
6-1.
Smooth backhand, hasn't he? Just rolls it over, plays the percentage as well.
Yeah.
1-7.
Burying the serves too, the hook serve that time, short into the forehand. Your opponent has a very strong backhand flick. He's a right-hander. Play it short forehand. Make it tough.
2-7.
He's beaten players, the Germans, such as Kirill Gerasimenko, Franziska, Falk, and Maharu Yoshimura. See why as well right now.
Yeah. He is growing leaps and bounds. Harder.
Let 8-2.
Chop block comes back.
8-3.
We are missing the master of the chop block, Kokiniwa.
Yes. Sad to see him retire, really.
Really sad, really sad.
It was like a generational reset after Tokyo, really, with Mitsutani and Kokiniwa retiring. Time for the future. Oh.
Wow.
Beautiful.
Lovely. 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 Lovely change of the flick.
That had a fanning backhand. Blocks, yeah, counters, the lock.
Change. I think, don't you think, Fraser, Koki retired very early? I don't think he's that old.
Early 30s, I think, but perhaps he'll be taking a coaching role. Wow, how has that come back, Ricardo Walter?
Beautiful, beautiful.
That is honestly his bread and butter. When he's back there, he offers something that not a lot do. This smash from Payas Jain had a lot of side spin, and yet he was able to counter like that.
9-5.
That's the power of a strong German.
Yeah. Every national team has certain players with a bit more feeling, a bit more flair. Often not their number one, actually, though.
Yeah.
Sometimes it can be frustrating as a coach because it's often the talented ones who are the laziest. I'm not saying Ricardo Walter is lazy, but just thinking about a few players I know personally.
But I think with Roscoff as a coach, you can't be lazy.
Not at all.
Is this a best of five or best of seven?
This is a best of five. Later on in the event, it will become best of seven.
One,
I believe the semi-final stage.
Next.
Both One, players two. Are going for long serves into the backhand. With a bit of backspin. Got one floatier there. Serving long with backspin is proving to become really, really effective because you almost feel obliged to attack it, and it's difficult to attack backspin.
Most of the people on the international circuit do the banana service, banana cut service. That's the more prevalent of the services which is done on the international circuit.
You mean the side spin backspin one?
Yeah, yeah, undercut and side spin and backspin one.
It's
3-2
for me.
2-3.
Did we have a review or something now?
Well, the point's been taken away.
I think we had a review for the edge point.
I see.
Lovely, that's a fantastic point.
Stunning point construction. No debate there from Pius Jenner. Just didn't. I don't think that the umpire caught the edge. Players obviously saw it. He's working that wide forehand angle well, isn't he, Walter? Two up. Goes for an intricate touch. Players are getting better and better at tangoing around the net. Keep it tight, deny the opponent the opening attack.
That leg is coming with a big spin. It had no spin at all.
We call that filthy in England. Do you have a name for this?
No.
If there's filth on the ball, it's like dirt. You don't know what it is. You think it's one thing and then it just drops off the racket.
He felt like it had a big spin, but it didn't have anything.
Got Walther where he wants him. What a point
there.
What
a point, what a recovery, what a recovery.
Just not over till it's over against Walther.
And with Europeans, this you call as fishing.
That's right.
This is fishing.
Lower than a lob. Gives the opponent slightly less time on the ball.
Again, that's a nice play, but I think got the lucky net card.
Yep, just slightly. Enough to distort the anticipation of trajectory there for Pius Jenner.
Correct.
Guess who we have waiting for us? Awaiting the winner of this match, Sunil. Guess who we have? We have the European champion, Cho Dang of Germany.
Wow. Wow.
4-7.
Fresh off coming runner up at the European top 16 in Montreux. Darko Jorgic, who is here as well, winning back to back. Top 10 in the world now, Jorgic.
Darko has the most lethal and the most powerful backhand in the world at present, I think.
I agree.
I am a great fan of his backhand. Yeah. Great fan.
It's like we're witnessing another Kalinikos Kriyanga at work.
Oh, maybe. maybe 50 times more speedier than Kriyanka.
Well, with the modern rubbers and whatnot, it's getting faster and faster, but the game is getting brought closer to the table and the strokes more short and sharp.
I think Fraser, it has got something to do with the ball, because the ball has become more lighter.
Yeah, for sure, from celluloid to plastic.
Yeah, it's become more lighter.
This is unreal. Well, whoa. If you wanted an exhibition, you'd hire Ricardo Walter. This guy can do everything. I think we just saw a forehand and a backhand chop block back to back. Stunning feeling. He's like an artist, isn't he?
Yeah.
Fine form here, the German. He's playing so freely.
Glad to see so many stars in a constellation here.
Brilliant, isn't it, really?
Yeah.
Befitting of this inaugural event.
Yeah.
It's a shame that we had Ma Long pull out.
If I tell you a little bit inside story, is half the India wanted to see Ma Long playing Goa, and many had booked the tickets hoping to see Ma Long.
I think he knew this, and that's why he made the apology video. Otherwise, it'd be a statement.
So that's very sad that Indians have missed him.
Yeah.
Half of my club has booked the tickets, and they have come to see Ma Long, because we have a very big picture on the wall in my club in Pune.
Oh wow! I'll have to come and pay that club a visit. I'd love to come and say hello. But Ricardo Walter saying goodbye to Pius Jen there with the backhand down the line. Again, his shot making is so smooth, relaxed.
That's the surprise I'm feeling, because Ricardo is playing so smooth and so very easy.
Yeah. Despite being the stronger and more experienced of the two players, I wouldn't have been surprised to see perhaps a 3-1. Not easy to beat Pius Jen 3-0.
Maybe Ricardo is too strong today.
Three all.
His best win, the Indian, is Brian Afanador of Puerto Rico, who he beat 4-1 of March last year, 77 in the world. Brian Afanador, so that was a nice win for the Indian, a bit of a confidence booster.
Yeah.
In trouble. Yeah. The percentages drop drastically when you're back there against a former top 30 world player who's looking to get back up to his highest level.
It's easy when someone is fishing to look at, but it's really difficult to implement.
As is that.
That's a good ball. Really good ball. Really good ball.
Nice compact counter. Continue to learn from the top men's level that it doesn't take a big stroke to produce a powerful stroke. Especially when there's already so much power on the ball. Use the power against your opponent.
Or you can use the power of the opponent to play as you want it.
Ooh, fortune there.
6-4.
It's a nice opening. He tried to go into the middle of Walter there. The crossover section. The German protected it with his backhand. Meant to go there, but obviously didn't intend to hit the net. Feels badly done by the Indian.
One of the most difficult strokes in table tennis is to hit in the center, and again, also to return that stroke also is very difficult.
Shovel serve with backspin, tight to the forehand. Still no real answer to that serve. slightly half-hearted flicker. I just think he was a little bit intimidated by how tight and low to the net it was, the Indian.
5-8.
And here the school kid's getting behind him.
Yeah.
He needs it.
Trying to buck him up.
8-6.
Two long serves.
Two long serves, 2 points.
Yeah.
Great. What a change in strategy.
Electric counter.
96.
1,000 volt forehand. The alarm bells rang as soon as he made contact with it, because he's very reliable at counter top spinning Walter. Doesn't miss many.
Counter top spin is the exact word you used, Fraser. That's coming to the vogue after this ball has come into the picture. Previously, people used to block. Now the counter top spin has come into vogue.
Another forehand miss with the flick there, and he wraps things up, Walter. A very strong performance against an opponent that could have been a potential banana skin.